Hey, teacher unions across the country continue protesting budget cuts like Governor Christie's while the debate about the poor condition of public schools rages on. But what's the solution to improving our education system? Nine-time Grammy Award winner, singer John Legend, is a passionate education advocate, and he's my guest this morning. Good morning to
you. Good morning. How are you?
Thank you so much for coming in and to talk about this, because I know you were a huge proponent of the documentary Waiting for Superman.
Absolutely.
And you sang a song, actually.
Yeah, I wrote a song for the film called Shine. Shine was basically inspired by the kids in the movie. They come from families that, you know, don't have the resources to send their kids to private school, but they want the best in education. And a lot of times in the neighborhoods the kids grow up in, they don't have the options to get a good education. And when a school pops up that's doing great things and great work, often there's a lot of competition to get into the school. There's a lottery. And it's kind of a travesty to see kids' future decided by a lottery. And so many kids don't have great educational choices in this country, and we're fighting to make sure that more kids do.
You know, what I loved about studying for this segment was that you said no matter how many times you've seen this documentary, and I saw it as well, that you're still brought to tears.
Absolutely.
Why are you so passionate about this?
Well, when it comes down to it, I know how much an education can change someone's life. I came from a working-class family in Ohio. I know that without an education, I wouldn't have had the opportunities that I had in life. And I know that way too many kids are not getting that opportunity today, and we need to make sure that they do.
There's another person who's trying to make a difference on education. Mm-hmm. Her name's Michelle Rhee. She was the chancellor of schools in D.C. Mm-hmm. She was on our show earlier, and here's what she talked about with regard to the teachers' unions.
Mm-hmm. The teachers' union leadership is exerting a tremendous amount of power. They have, between the NEA and the AFT together, the two national teachers' unions, they have a budget of about $2.2 billion a year. They spend about $500 million of that a year on political activities. So they're exerting their influence. And for the most part, they don't represent the interests of the rank-and-file members.
And how would you respond to that?
Well, I think the teachers' unions have to be careful to make sure that what they're fighting for is in the best interest of the students. And I think it's a careful balance we have to strike when we talk about this, because we don't want to demonize teachers, because teachers are the solution.
Of course.
Teachers, great teachers are what can transform a school. Great teachers, passionate teachers are the ones that can change people's lives. We just have to make sure that the work rules that are negotiated between the unions and the government, that the work rules for the teachers are in the best interest of the students. And a lot of times that's not the case, and we need to make sure that happens.
Mm-hmm. I think that's everyone's mission here. I mean, we all honor the teachers.
Absolutely.
Because we all can remember the great teachers in our lives.
Absolutely,
right?
And we need to value them as a society, and particularly in this era of, you know, we have to cut the budget and we have to cut spending and all these things. I think we do this country a disservice if we decide that that means we have to cut a bunch of teachers and we have to cut spending on education, because education is so important. It's such an important investment. And if we're thinking about the future of this country, the future of this country is riding on making sure that we compete in the future, and education is such a key to that.
And you're going to be making a huge announcement today.
Yes.
You came to our studio
with
not teachers,
I came
but
with
wonderful
a crew of students, yes,
who are over here. Now, I understand that they are the finalists in Samsung's Solve for Tomorrow. What is the contest?
Well, Solve for Tomorrow is all about focusing on science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, which the acronym
STEM.
For that is STEM. So, as a lot of people know, America continues to fall behind in all kinds of categories in education, but particularly in the important areas of math and science, where, you know, a lot of jobs in the future and a lot of jobs now are in those areas, but we continue to fall behind most developed countries when it comes to educating our kids in those areas. And so Samsung decided we want to do something to encourage innovation, encourage creativity, and encourage our young people to get more excited about math and science. And so they started this competition called Solve for Tomorrow. And the kids here today are the ones that made the best submissions, the most inspired submissions for this contest. And Samsung's going to give them some great technology to help encourage
I understand.
Them.
It's $1 million in technology
for
a classroom. So congratulations to all of them, by the way. They are the finalists. You will announce the winner later on today. How wonderful to meet you and
My
talk
pleasure.
About something that's your passion besides your wonderful musical
Thank
talent.
You very much.
Thanks, John Legend.
My pleasure.